Jewish, and the producer is Jewish. You'll see here in a second. His times of Israel, in Israel, reference in Game of Thrones. If there's a reference here, could the blowing up of the Septs be a metaphor or predictive programming for the destruction of the Dome of the Rock? I think it's possible. Producer of the show. Here she is in 2012 at the Comic-Con panel, and again in 2015 at the panel. She's one of the top producers on the show. Her name is Carolyn Strauss. She was the former president of HBO until 2008, and it says here, being of Jewish descent, in 2015, she signed as one of the 98 members of the LA Jewish community an open letter supporting the proposed nuclear agreement between Iran and six war powers led by the United States as being in the best interest of the United States. So she is a president of HBO. Now she's a producer of Game of Thrones. Very likely she could have some connections to some of these Roosevelt the Temple people. So I'm just throwing out there, this could be predictive programming. So the next bit of predictive programming is Alex Jones with his prediction. And there's a caveat here, though, because Alex Jones is a total Zionist shill, as I've been documenting lately, as a lot of people know. So this prediction he gives is not what is actually going to happen. It's the cover story, what they're going to say. So he's saying, well, I'll show it to you.
Islamic takeover happened in Jerusalem. Guaranteed, within 1 year, Dome of the Rock, all of it's going to get blown sky high.
There you go. He says Muslims, ISIS, Palestine, Muslims, Arabs are going to blow up the Dome of the Rock. That's their most, one of their most religious holy sites, and which is just this ridiculous prediction by Alex Jones. He's a lot smarter than this. He knows all these about this messianic prophecy and rebuilding the temple. So for him to say, to predict that the Muslims are going to do it, makes me think that he's trying to prime his audience to accept that the Muslims doing it, but it's really going to be a Zionist false flag. So why should we listen to what Alex Jones has to say? Well, he kind of predicted 9/11. He said it was going to be blamed on bin Laden, and that it was really the government that did it.
And that we're aware of who the terrorists are if you pull this. This could stop the Hitlerian Reichstag event.
July 25th, 2001, this is what he says.
I want you to fly to the White House and I'm preparing for martial law. Terrorism. We know who to blame. The point is, if any terrorism comes, it's from this government. And if there was an outside threat like a bin Laden, who was a known CIA asset in the 80s, running the Mujahideen War, whose family builds all the military bases over in Saudi Arabia right now, and sits at the border of the Iranian satellite.
Okay, so Alex Jones predicted 9/11 pretty accurately, and a lot of people suspected that he could have had some inside knowledge about that, and that he was kind of in the controlled gatekeeper, controlled opposition to steer everybody away from Zionist involvement into it's an inside job and dead ends, and he's, in the last few years, he's essentially betrayed 9/11. So, he predicts that the Arabs are going to blow it sky high, and that's just one thing. Now, you have a few other connections that are going to make this sink in way harder.
In 1 year, Dome of the Rock, all of it is going to get blown sky high.
So he said this on December 6, 2017, and so we have until the end of this year, basically, to see the dome get blown up. Will he be right? So this is another example of Alex Jones possibly knowing something about the Dome of the Rock. This is another video that he put out when, this is the time frame when Obama had vetoed, or we didn't veto, we abstained from vetoing the resolution that would say Israel's settlements are illegal. So he has some huge exaggeration. Israel wants to overthrow Israel, and why is Obama doing this? But the title of this video is, why is Obama putting Israel in the crosshairs? And the thumbnail is odd, because when you think of Israel, you don't think of the Dome of the Rock. You think of, like, Star David or a menorah or Netanyahu or something like that, or maybe just the map of Israel. When you think of the Dome of the Rock, you think of Muslims. I mean, it's essentially a mosque. So why would he have a target on there if this isn't some kind of weird symbology? Because he doesn't, in this video, he doesn't talk about the dome. He doesn't talk about any of this stuff. So it doesn't fit. And that's not enough. So one of these guys who's all about Trump and prophecies, this guy Trey Smith, he's got a YouTube channel, he's really popular. And he's the one that's saying Trump is Cyrus and he's going to rebuild the temple. Here's a little bit of him.
So this man, Donald Trump, is like a modern-day Cyrus. I find that absolutely fascinating.
Before the 2016 presidential election, he's not the only one. A lot of people are saying this, but Trey Smith, predicting Trump, doing all this kind of prophecies and numerology with Trump, and he's a guest on InfoWars' show. So InfoWars is totally aware of all this Israel worship and this rebuilding the temple stuff.
I'm Millie Weaver, and you are watching the InfoWars Christmas Spectacular Extravaganza. Now, we have an awesome guest who, really, I am a big fan of him, Trey Smith. Many of you guys who don't know him, he has a very popular YouTube channel, and he makes the most interesting, amazing miniature documentaries about, you know, prophecies, esotericism, the Bible, Israel.
So these are Trump prophecies that he's Cyrus and he's going to rebuild the temple. And he's on our show here. He's in studio with Darren McBreen. He says that he's an InfoWars employee. He says, yes, Trey Smith in the house. And his headline is Rick Derringer, crew in the house, never a dull moment. So here's Rick Derringer. He went with Trey Smith to Israel to film this documentary. And he's a guest on the show, and listen to the kind of stuff he says about Trump and his prophecy.
God seems to also really like numbers and mathematics. Pastor, what is the year that we're coming up on that he's finding these prophecies of Trump in? It's the year 5-7-7-7. It's that same book of Daniel, Daniel 9:25, where God gives the exact day and date that Jesus Christ would ride the donkey to the front gate of Jerusalem.
We hear right now, we hear the 5-7-7-6, the 5-7-7-7, and changing that we hear basically is October the 30th of this year. Now, we hear
showing Isaiah there a second ago. And he's saying it's all going to repeat again, and Trump is the new Cyrus, and he's going to rebuild, he's a builder, that kind of thing, you get the point. But anyway, this guy goes on Alex Jones' show. So, Alex Jones predicting that the Muslims are going to do it when it's the Jews that want to do it, it's like, I just see right through it. I'm very suspicious of this. And it gets even crazier, even crazier. Look at this part. So, there, when I was doing this research of blowing up the Dome of the Rock, this came up. It is I Pet Goat 2. It's a short cartoon, and it's got all of this Illuminati symbolism and Antichrist prophecy stuff. And I took a few of the best little clips out, but you should definitely go watch the whole thing for yourself. It's only about 7 minutes, but let's get that started. First of all, a goat represents Baphomet. And this is I Pet Goat 2. And I go online and look up this thing. There's all this analysis on YouTube, people trying to figure out what this is. And very interesting commentary. Statue of Liberty with hexagram, a Star of David below it. Wonder what that means. Check out the whole thing for yourself, but so in the comments of this video, everybody's saying he's the Antichrist, this Illuminati worship, and New World Order stuff. The video is a sign of things to come. This Jesus figure is the Antichrist, the leader of the future one world religion. Notice economic collapse, then World War III, followed by the destruction of Islam, and the inclusion of pagan religions. The shit is about to start. One more. He is Antichrist, not Jesus. So here's a slow-mo of the scene where they destroy, the imagery looks like it's destroying the Dome of the Rock on the Temple Mount. Here's a zoomed-in slow motion. So, you know that I came across this just yesterday, and then look what pops up. The creator of this just happened to be interviewed by...
Simply breathtaking. That is I Pet Goat 2, and the gentleman that made it is going to be joining us here via video Skype in just a moment. The art type of images in it, a lot of people have projected onto it their own thoughts, their own ideas, and they say the most powerful art out there, you know, especially designed to do that. Some people have said it's satanic, and it's programming us. Louis Lefebvre is joining us now. From a city north of Montreal, as a 3D animator, director, and entrepreneur, and he joins us. Very excited to have him on again. You just saw the piece. We're going to analyze it here. Well, Louis, do you need to be burned at the stake? Is this actually satanic programming? All right, Louis Lefebvre, an amazing artist, and people can claim the devil if they want, but there's no doubt that you're an amazing artist. Thank you so much.
Thanks for your time.
Wow. Well, very, very powerful, ladies and gentlemen, and it gets you thinking.
Gets you thinking. So I watched this interview yesterday, and it was so odd, because it didn't seem like this guy made the video. He may have, but he said he had some help. Who knows who those people were. Definitely into the occult. And prophecies, but all the comments on this video, on this Alex Jones interview video, are saying the same thing, is that this guy lying, that Alex Jones is covering up the truth behind this movie. You look at this, wow, he's totally lying. Clearly, the figure is not the Christ. This is insane. So nobody buys this creator of this cartoon's explanations of what this stuff means. Am I the only one who took this Christ figure as the Antichrist? This guy didn't make the video. He's just a bullshit artist. Did this for spin after its release. Confirmation that Alex Jones is a shill. His director is just another one of these Illuminati puppets making money. A few more. This guy is a liar. He's hiding the portrayal, the ushering in of the Antichrist. He has certainly been paid to make this video. A lot of predictive programming, like the Dome of the Rock being blown up in this movie, which is way too deep for this Trojan horse AJ to understand. I don't feel like we're getting the full picture, so everybody, go to the video. It's still up. You can see it. Everybody in the comments doesn't buy this. After watching this clip, I'm thoroughly convinced that Alex Jones is not working for the New World Order. Anyone that has seen iPad Go-To flicks know that this is riddled with Illuminati references, and that the director acts like it's just some weird flick. So all this stuff with Alex Jones, he makes this bizarre prediction. He has this weird thumbnail that doesn't make any sense, showing the Dome of the Rock in the targets. He's got this Trey Smith biblical prophecy guy in studio and on the show, and then he's got interviews with this guy who made the Pet Goat video with all this Illuminati Antichrist symbolism, and Jones just like whitewashes the whole thing. So, what do you guys think about this? Am I crazy? Or am I on to something here? Because, you know, all the Jewish connections with the Game of Thrones and Alex Jones and his history of predicting the false flag correctly. And here's another interesting aspect of this. Sheldon Adelson, he was Trump's biggest campaign contributor. This is the New Yorker, says he's the kingmaker. So he's gives more money than anybody to Republicans. He's a huge Zionist. Here is Guardian, Sheldon Adelson-backed Trump trip to Israel after $100 million pledge. Here's Guardian again, Sheldon Adelson to give $25 million boost to Trump super PAC. Jerusalem Post, last minute, Adelson flushes Trump campaign with cash. Sheldon Adelson gave a record $5 million for Trump inauguration. Time, Sheldon Adelson, all Israel, all the time. So the biggest contributor to Trump's campaign is Sheldon Adelson, an Israel first Zionist, who is obsessed with having a temple rebuilt and having an embassy in Jerusalem and having the capital be Jerusalem. Here's how it is. Adelson reportedly disappointed with Trump over Jerusalem embassy moved away. And GOP member Adelson furious over Tillerson's Israel comments report. And here's Adelson furious over Trump's waffling on Jerusalem embassy. So Trump didn't do it immediately, so he's pissed. But when Trump finally did announce the embassy move, Sheldon Adelson offers to pay for the embassy. I mean, over the top insanity here. And all these Jews and Christians think that the Antichrist is coming and Jesus is returning with Trump. For many, if CNN, for me, many evangelists, Jews, Jerusalem is about prophecy, not politics. Here's Newsweek. Will Trump have the arrival of the Messiah? Jews and evangelicals think so. CNN, why evangelicals are, quote, ecstatic about Trump's Jerusalem rule. Jerusalem, like people Trump with their sirens with Trump on the inside. And Jerusalem Post, Trump's election herald is coming, the Messiah says here. So, rabbi guy. And the U.S. media line table for moving embassy to Jerusalem. So Trump, thank you.